Welcome to the Math 1 lesson summary video for the task Something to Chew On
and Solidify Understanding Task. So, as you can see at the top, the purpose of this task is to solidify student understanding of arithmetic sequences by introducing them to a scenario where the sequence is decreasing. So we have the Food Mart grocery store, and we have the candy machine. So each time a child inserts a quarter, 7 candies come out of the machine. It's an important piece of information. The machine holds 15 pounds of candy. It's an important piece of information. And then each pound of candy contains about 180 individual candies. So if I want to represent the total number of candies, which is the first thing I'm asked to do in the task, I need to combine this orange highlighted sentence with this green highlighted sentence. So if I have 15 pounds of candy in the machine, and each pound has 180 candies, well then 15 times 180 is 2,700 candies in the machine. So we have a scenario where we're starting with that many candies, and they're decreasing over time. So when we've got 0 customers, the number of candies will be 2,700. The first customer will put in their quarter, get 7 candies out, and that will bring us down to 2,693. Then the next customer will take their candies out. That will bring us down to 2,680, mental math, 6. And then we'll get down to 2,679. And then another customer will come, 2,672. And the fifth customer will come, we'll be down to 2,665 candies. So you can see, if I'm trying to answer the question that it also asks in problem 1, when will the machine be empty, it's going to take quite a long time using a table. So it's going to be helpful to create some representations of this scenario. So let's start with a recursive rule. So I might have f of n equals f of n minus 1 minus 7, because we're subtracting 7 candies every time, starting at f of 0 equaling 2,700. Or if I wanted to do an explicit rule, I could do f of n equals 2,700, the starting amount, minus 7n. And that would be a good explicit rule. So I can use that to answer the question, when will the machine be empty? So f of n represents the number of candies, and n represents the number of customers. So if I want to know when the machine is going to be empty, I need to plug in 0 for f of n. So I get 0 equals 2,700 minus 7n. So throwing back to Math 8 in the 8th grade, you know how to solve equations like these, two-step equations. So we could subtract 2,700 on both sides. We get negative 2,700 equals negative 7n, and then divide both sides by negative 7. And we're going to get n equals, well, negative divided by negative is going to be positive, and that is 385.7 customers later after the first. So really the 386th customer is going to get ripped off a little bit, because there's not going to be enough candy in there for them to get 7. So I think it would make the most sense to say that it will be empty after 386 customers, even though that last one is getting ripped off. So the important idea here that we want to take out of this problem, going back to the purpose, is that this is the first scenario where our common difference was negative. Our common difference in this problem was negative 7. And so we saw that represented here in our recursive formula and here in our explicit rule. And so that's something to consider. Then we have another scenario that extends on this idea. It says we want to represent the amount of money. This is much simpler, so I'm going to go through it quickly. So if every customer is spending a quarter or 25 cents, at 0 customers, we will of course have $0. First customer will be 25 cents. Second customer will be 50 cents. Third customer will be 75 cents. Fourth customer will be $1. And then every four customers, it's going to increase by a dollar. So on and so on. So after eight customers, we'll have $2. After 12, we would have $3. After 16, we'd have $4. And on and on and on. So when will the machine have $25? We can use the rule f of n equals 0.25 times n. And so that's going to be $25 equals 0.25 n. This is a one-step equation dividing both sides by 0.25. And we get n equals 100 customers. So when will the machine have $25? After 100 customers. All right, thanks for watching. If you need help specifically with the Ready, Set, Go homeworks, make sure to check out the Canvas student support site for aligned videos to the Ready, Set, Go problems.